Deke, how's it going? Had some time on my hands, made you some shit.
Booze, man? Thank you, brother. I'll be by.
St. John, stop by the hot springs when you can.
Tucker, I hear you. St. John out.
Marauders taking out freaks, yeah? Go at it, fellas.
So, you want to learn how to hunt? Is that what I'm hearing?
I know how to shoot a gun.
It's a rifle, not a gun.
I was in the 10th Mountain Cope. Don't give me any Marine Corps bullshit.
Killing a buck's a little different than killing a man. Or a freak. Best way to hunt an animal is to track it. You gotta focus. And see what nature's trying to tell you. If you look hard enough, you'll see the signs.
I can use these.
Okay, then. Look hard. See this pile of deer scat? It's fresh.
Yeah, I see it.
They lead this way.
Yeah, I can see that.
Well, come on, then. Quick, there's your buck.
I see him.
Now here, use my rifle. If you were in the 10th Mountain, you know how to use a scope.
Yeah, Cope, I know how to use a scope.
Easy, easy.
I got this.
Got him.
I got him.
Nice shot.
Oh, goddammit, it wasn't a kill shot. He got away.
No, no, that's okay. You wounded him. He'll bleed out soon enough. We just gotta track him.
Okay.
See the blood spots? Look close.
Yeah, I see him.
And follow him.
On it.
He'll be slowing down about now. Losing too much blood. We should be coming across his carcass anytime now. Okay, you know how to gut an animal?
Yeah, look. Cope, Boozer, and I have been hunting before. He used to go elk hunting with his old man, and yeah, he showed me how to gut a deer.
Well, let's just say, no disrespect to Boozer, but you've got a lot to learn. You're wasting a lot of meat there. Overall, not bad for a beginner.
Yeah, thanks.
Now, I'll take back that rifle.
Here, thanks.
Like I said, Deke, we can always use more venison at the camp. Still got some folks trying to heal up from that Ripper attack.
Okay, Cope. Yeah, I'll see if I can remember that.
Hey, Deke.
Manny?
Yeah, got some good stuff in stock.
We don't have the tools. You know? I mean, ever.
No. How do you expect us to fix anything around here?
I'll refuel you nice and good. Okay, man.
What's up?
All right, check back later, man.
Deke,
see,
how have you been?
Damon.
I think we're gonna run out.
You're back. It's good to see you again.
Jazzy, how's my girl?
Oh, okay. Hey, Deke, you stay safe, okay?
Hey, Deke, how's it going?
Hey, Damon, how's the gun trade going?
You definitely need that. All right. You come here if you need anything.
Maybe laundry.
Open the gate already.
I know him.
That's it for now.
You people can stand this. Oh, it's killing me. And is this even enough food?
Guess we'll find out.
How's it going?
Hey, what's up?
We're gonna run out of this someday, you know.
Okay.
Bye.
What do you want?
Deke, I need you to go after someone.
Go after someone? Okay, what's going on?
Can you get the generator going?
Right after you brought in that girl, Lisa. Larson brings in another one. Name was Rose Allen, a weak little thing. But we figured she could pull her own weight, help us get this irrigation ditch done.
Okay. So, what do you need?
She's gone. She went on a supply run with Alki, some others, up to that abandoned Nero refugee camp. You know, the one, I think you've been up there before.
Yeah, I know the one.
Find her, Deke. There's been a bunch of drifters and squatters spotted up that way. If they find her first...
Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna see what I can do.
It's on the menu tonight.
Hold on, I'll get
some. Drifter brought it in.
I think we're gonna run out. Vegetarian.
I guess those days are gone.
You here for your bike?
Just having a look.
Hold on, I'll get the bike.
How's it going, Booze Man?
Fine, goddammit. Hey, Deke, we're getting low on supplies. Could use some more meat if you get a chance.
Oh, shit. Okay. Guess it's been a while since we did any hunting. I'll see if I can scare up some meat while I'm out.
You remember what you're doing?
He's out!
You were saying?
You remember what you're doing?
Yeah, I had Cope give me a few pointers, believe it or not.
Cope? Shit, I don't believe it. Thanks, Steve.
See you, Booth, man. Alright, now I just gotta find some meat. Deer, bear, wolf, fuck, don't matter to me.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. I grew up in these here woods. My grandfather taught me all about hunting. Funny how it still works in a world he never would have dreamed of. I built my first treehouse to use as a deer blind. Getting height on your target helps your aim and keeps you safe. Back then, I took out my first doe from up top. Today, my camp's up in the trees. You want to survive and can contribute, you come to me. Got you covered. Grandfather also taught me to catch a doe. Sometimes you gotta lay an ambush. Hide where they need to go. Like a watering hole. Today, you're as likely to be prey as hunter. So you gotta keep your eyes peeled when you're hitting up places we all need to go. But Grandfather always said the easiest way to a good meal was to lay a trap. Put a snare by a tree, and you could have dinner next time you come round. But careful. A headless snake can still bite. Especially when it ain't really dead. My grandfather would have outlived us all. Let me tell you. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Well, that's great, Cope. So you and your granddaddy set traps for him, and you and your old man used to lay down salt licks. Yeah, that's real sporting. I guess none of that shit matters now. Might be useful. Hey, about that location where the girl was last seen. Looks like they got hit by a swarm. If she was here, probably not much chance she's still alive.
If she is, you'll find her. Tuck her out.
Oh, God damn it, Spears. Yeah, not bad. Okay. Finally, Jesus. Take a closer look. All right, where? I mean, might be here somewhere, right?
Jesus, looks like the swarm tore them apart. Poor bastards.
Rose? Rose Allen, right?
No! No!
Hey, I'm not gonna hurt you. See, I'm not with those assholes.
No! No!
God damn it, I'm here to help. Tucker sent me. Wait, I said that I am here to help you.
No, you're with her. You're from the work camp.
No, I'm with Tucker. I do runs for, yeah.
They starved me. I wouldn't follow her orders, so they wouldn't feed me.
Woman, it's a work camp. I mean, everyone's gotta work.
I'm not a slave. I'm not going back, do you hear me? I'd rather die out here.
Okay, goddammit. Go on. Gate already.
Open it up. It's okay.
Hey, man.
Hey, how's it going?
Fill her up.
I got you covered.
Come back soon. Later.
Yeah?
How you doing?
What's happening?
This will do you good out there. Can I get anything else for you?
Okay, sure.
Okay.
Can I help you?
Hey, what's going on?
Tucker, Deacon St. John Day. Deacon St. John to Ada Tucker.
Deke, did you find her?
Yeah, Tuck, I found her, and she's on her way back.
Wait, you let her go? Alone?
Well, she took one of the squatter's bikes. She said that she was going to be able to find her way. She didn't want my help.
Oh, God damn it, Deke. You should have brought her in.
Well, why, Tuck? Why? Is something wrong? I mean, is there some reason she wouldn't want to come back?
No, of course not. It's just a kid like Rose. She doesn't have a goddamn clue about what's out there.
Well, I don't know, Tuck. Maybe she does. St. John out.
Let's take a look around. What do we got? Still got this. This is it. Bunch of murderers and vagrants would just as soon shoot you as look at you.
Hold on, I'm coming.
You're gonna die out here. I know of a camp where it's safe.
Camp? Where? Show me. I'll go. Go toward Three Finger Jack, find the Salome Hot Springs, talk to Alki Turner. He'll help you out.
I was done for. Shit! You know? Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Oh, man.
Yeah, let him know it was Deacon St. John. You know.
I just keep running. Stay off the road.
rats if they see me out dead. Get Mo and ammo.
Don't let him! We can do this!
Should've seen that coming.
Get the bastard! Run at him! Kill them!
Hey, let me in.
Hey, open it up. He's okay. Deacon, how you been? Need fuel? Bike's probably thirsty. Yep, always needing fuel. Drifter life.
Hey.
What's up with you?
Deacon St. John.
Damon.
What can I get you? Now that's what I'm talking about. I'll fix that gun up for you, nice and good. All right. I'll be seeing you.
Deacon St. John.
Hey, Deke, how's it going?
Hey, Damon, how's life?
Keep bringing in more parts. Never getting out of here.
Just gotta find the carcass. Gotta take a closer look.
Scrap. fresh, Nate. That ought to do it. Okay, I just gotta get this back to Boozer.
If you were coming back or not.
Hey, you know I wouldn't leave you out here.
You gonna be up all night?
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. Hey, booze man. I brought in some meat. Should keep us stocked up for a while.
Hey, Deke, thanks, man. I'm not real hungry right now. I'll salt it up in a bit.
Just gotta close my eyes for a bit. All right, okay. Let's go.
chance, okay? Let me get back to work.
Brian, this has got to be it.
Sarge, how about we make an unscheduled stop on our way back? A couple of samples. Bull traps I want to check.
Hey, Doc, how long before your job done?
I'm not a doctor. I keep telling you that.
Sorry, Lieutenant O'Brien. How long are we going to be here?
Well, that takes a moment. I thought I saw something in our approach. I'm going to check it out.
Yeah?
It's probably nothing. Fresh carry.
Okay, Doc. Lieutenant, go become carrion yourself.
Only animals can become carrion, Corbin, not humans. You guys checked the perimeter, right?
I heard something.
Yeah, it's clear.
Anyone else hear that?
Field note 2006. On approach to the landing site, I observed a large swarm of insects, probably Entomosotrophis or Diptera, in a clearing well away from our designated target. From that distance, I cannot discern what was attracting the insects, but from the size of the swarm, recent carrion is indicated. Should be just over here. Damn it, where is
the fuck was that?
Speculation as to Tabanisotratus is confirmed. Lots of horse flies here. I'm glad to have the suit on. Let me tell you, carrion is still mostly intact and appears to be.
Well, look at it this way, you poor son of a bitch. At least you weren't torn apart by freaks. If you lived a few more weeks, you might have become one yourself, and would have that been something. What do you want? Stay back.
I just want to talk.
Nero Protocol 2-7 states clearly that if conducting operations in quarantine zones, if I encounter any civilians or civilians, that I'm forbidden from making contact.
Really? See, that sounded to me like making contact.
Yes. Yes, it did.
You're alive.
Yes. I am.
How? How are you alive,
O'Brien? What? I don't understand.
Okay. You were there. That night. Farewell. The next night, refugee
Nero
camp.
Protocol 2-7 states.
Everyone was dead. They were slaughtered. Torn limb from goddamn limb.
Protocol
All right, listen up. We're going to do this the easy way or the hard way. The easy way, we have a little chat. You give me the information that I need, and then you go back to digging your way through freaker shit or whatever the hell else you're doing out here. The hard way. Crack open that little space suit, and then we see what your friends out there have to say about you breathing in all this contaminated air. So what's it gonna be, O'Brien?
Yes. Okay. Okay.
You remember the rooftop of the old brewery? I put a woman on your chopper. She was wounded.
Yes. I remember, a knife wound. She was cut pretty bad.
I went to the refugee camp that you said you were taking her to. Everyone was dead, so I'm going to ask you again. How did you survive?
We weren't there. We were diverted south to another camp. Like you said, the camp in Belknap was overrun, so they moved us south to a camp outside of Silver Lake.
Were there survivors?
You mean now? I don't know. I was transferred to the research unit.
Did she survive?
Oh, wait. I can find out. I can check. You have one of our radios. That's how you... I can't promise anything, but
I'll check.
Uh-huh, and I'm gonna go with you.
No, you can't, please. You don't. Hey, you don't understand. I'll fucking shoot you.
Not before I shoot you.
Okay, look, if you're gonna fucking kill me, do it, okay? I did my job. Did that woman, your wife? I put her on oxygen, I gave her an IV. I kept her alive. I got in a lot of trouble for that. She was septic, she wasn't gonna make it, but I got her to the mass unit. I saved her goddamn life!
O'Brien, report.
I have to go. Please, you have to get out of here. You don't know these men. You don't know
O'Brien,
what they're capable of.
If I don't hear from you, I don't care how long it takes, I'm gonna track you down. And I'm gonna do a lot worse than snap off an antenna.
I'm sorry about your wife. But you're not the only one who lost someone that night.
Soon, Boozer. Real soon. Look, as soon as your arm heals, we're gonna be riding the hell out of here.
Yeah, Deke. Okay. Deke, you got your radio on? I crafted you a couple of items if you want to swing by.
Boozer, thank you. Yeah, I'll stop by when I can. Deacon out. O'Brien. Are you out there? O'Brien! Oh, you son of a bitch, you better radio me. You hear me, O'Brien? I know you're on this channel. God damn it. Okay, you better get back to me or I'm going to track you down. You got that? Oh, God damn it, oh, come on! O'Brien! Back!
Deke, you there? Did you track down the chopper? Was it the same guy, the one we saw on the roof that night?
Yeah, it was him.
Did he remember us? Sarah, what happened?
I don't know. They got diverted south. He remembered her, but he doesn't know what happened to her.
You don't know if she's still alive.
What? No. I mean, no. Look, I'm not stupid, Boozer. I just want to find out.
Down you go.
What? No. I mean, no. Look. What? No. I mean, no, look, I'm not stupid, Boozer. I just want to find out, you know, what happened to her, where she died.
Well, hey, maybe you can finally, I don't know, find some peace.
I don't need to find any peace, Jesus, Boozer. I gotta go, all right? Deacon out.